Water brought me here to this Indian River Lagoon coast, and it's been running through me ever since. So I was a fishing guide, and I spent 300 days a year on the water. And it fed my family, and I felt like I could give back to it, because the fish we caught, we didn't usually kill, we released them. And we would come back, and a lot of times we'd catch those same fish again. And then over time of spending time on the water, my concern started growing about what we were doing to the water and what we could do to protect the water. And the more that concern grew, the more I knew I needed to work in my circle of influence so that we'd become better stewards of that water. I think that we're all becoming more aware of water. Now, we're not aware of water like the woman this morning in Nairobi that lives in a polluted slum with a million other people. A slum that's in unbelievable. It's five blocks, and they've got to get water, and clean water is their day. And they understand the value of water much better than my daughter that just woke up and turned on the sink and splashed clean water in her face. Of course, we should think about that with water at all times. So for me, my balance in my life has been water. And the word that comes to me now is, it resurrects me every day, you know, because every day I've got to remember how fortunate I am. And the reason that I'm rich is because of water. And I can't imagine how it would be without it. So, and I know that so many people haven't woken up yet to know that, but they will. They'll wake up. You know, I have faith and I have hope. I have faith.